comedian John Edward, and we are packed to the rafters thanks to you. You can pull a crowd. You really can. All of these people would love to be read by you, John, so I guess we're in your hands.
Okay. Well, thank you guys for having me.
In the watermelon jumper, yes.
Okay. I came to your show last year and you had someone come through and you said you couldn't talk to him because the family hadn't been told, and my son died that day.
Okay, say that again.
When you did your show last year, your first show,
okay,
someone came through to you to talk and you said, no, you couldn't because the family hadn't been informed yet.
I wouldn't
and
say
when
that.
When I got home, I found out my son had died.
So you were at the event?
Yeah. Oh, it's here. Yeah.
Here in the show?
Yeah.
Here in the studio?
And you said you couldn't pass on any message because the family hadn't been told yet, and I wanted to know if it was him.
I actually wouldn't remember that. We were just talking before the show, and they were telling me something that had taken place, and I said, I made a reference. I said, I kind of feel like I have, like, Mediumheimer's, where, like, I don't remember the readings. They're like borrowed thoughts. So I usually don't have that kind of restraint, to be honest. That's why I'm like, I don't think I would say that. I usually like blurt stuff out and then go, oops.
Patricia was there too.
So tell me exactly, or maybe they could show me what exactly I said.
Oh, just about the family don't know that you've passed over.
So you were here in the studio, and when you left here, you found out that what I was saying, that he had passed. I am so sorry. So I don't think there's any accident that they're actually asking me to come to you after you heard me say what I just said here. Okay? So what was that last November that I was?
June. He died June the 17th.
Yeah, I'm not feeling him. That does not mean that he's not around you or that he's okay. And
it was just so coincidental. I got home, and then Laola, because he's from Perth, and I got the phone call.
I am so sorry, but I'm gonna tell you that many years ago, I was doing an event for this woman. Not this woman. I was doing an event in Phoenix. Hundreds of people were there, and there was a grandmotherly type woman, and she had a couple of people with her, and I made a connection with her daughter who had passed. And her daughter kept giving me a date over and over and over and over and over. Big deal. And I knew it was so big because all their family on the other side were coming together for this big event. So I said to her, I go, is there like a party or something? Like they're all coming together for this big event. And she's like, no. But I kept going at it over and over and over and over and over and over. So during the course of that, I kept alluding to it like being this big family surprise. Shocking surprise. That was in June. That October, they came to San Diego. I was doing a book signing. Thankfully, I was seated. They came up to the table, the woman standing in front of me, and she said, I want to say thank you. And I'm looking at her, and I'm thinking, like, I didn't remember reading her today. And I said, did I read you? And she said, no, not here. You read me in Phoenix. Upon which I said, what I normally would say is, like, I'm so sorry, I don't remember you. And she goes, no, you'll remember me. And I went, I will? I'm like, why am I gonna remember you? And she goes, the date, you kept going on and on. And sure enough, I did. I went, oh my God, surprise party? She said, no, my son was murdered. That's why I was glad I was sitting. And I looked at her and I was like, oh my God, I'm so sorry. She says, well, I'm here to thank you. Now, my logical, analytical, New York cop son brain doesn't go to the thank you place. I went to the, why do you wanna thank me? Why aren't you mad at me for not seeing what it actually was? And she said to me, she goes, no. She goes, you gave me the only solace in a very, very dark moment. And I said, how so? She goes, you told me my entire family was gonna be there for this big surprise event. She goes, and that's what's making me deal with this. I lost one daughter and now I lost my son. So she's like, so I have to thank you. And I was like, but why are you not mad at me? She goes, no, honey, that's up to God. She goes, I'll take care of him when I get there. And that's the reality. So I feel like there are moments that happen, and if we had one, then they gave you the information, or maybe he came through and let you know before you even knew. And when it's the right time, I think when it's the right time, you're going to have probably a more spectacular experience without a medium than you can ever possibly want, which is usually a visit and usually comes in a dream state.
I dreamt that he came to me.
That's why.
And I said, Mum, I love you and I'm sorry. Because he was a fireman and he asphyxiated. So a couple of the stories relate to the same type of thing.
Who's the M name?
His name was Maury and they called him Moz.
So you're okay, so now he's going to make me a liar after I tell you the big story, right? Is there a Lyle or a...
His daughter's oldest daughter is Lauren.
Lauren.
They were going to do Kokoda track together, and she's still doing it this year in memory of him for Beyond Blue.
Would he be 50?
He would have been 49. He would have been 50.
He's telling me to talk about turning 50.
December.
This year he would turn 50? He's making me feel like you're going to celebrate his 50th birthday. Are you normally not somebody who uses curse words? I mean, seriously, like, looking at you, you do not strike me as dropping the F-bomb. Like, that's not...
If the venue arises, yes.
I'm supposed to say he was with you when you repetitively kept saying that over and over again. So I don't know if when you found out he passed, that's the word you kept using over and over and over.
Yeah, cursed.
Okay. One word over and over and over and over is what he's showing me. Then I feel like you need to know he's okay. Are you like an amazing like baker or something? Like I'd like to say
I'm
like
a cook. I like cooking.
Okay, so what's the pie or the sweet thing I'm supposed to be bringing up?
Lemon meringue pie. Oh,
yeah. Is that like...
It was his favorite. It was...
And did you tell him he was out of this world or he was interplanetary or he was galactic or did he like have an obsession with NASA? Why am I seeing space?
Oh, is it? I don't know. He was into everything.
No, I'm seeing space. Like, I'm seeing, like, space.
I don't know.
I don't know what this is. Did you, like, go see Star Wars with him or something? Or, like,
no,
did he take
he
you to...
No, he wasn't to Star Wars or anything like that.
I'm in
he
space.
Was outside, outdoor-y. I'm Star Wars. I'm a Trekkie.
So then where could I have gone, where could you have gone that he could have been with you in the last year or so that has me inside something spaceship-like? Did you go to an exhibit? Were you someplace that, like, are you, like, standing in front of Darth Vader, or?
I flew to Brisbane because he was my first husband's child, and to celebrate the anniversary of his death with his daughter in the plane.
Okay.
And my first husband has remarried and his son is a Trekkie. He's right into the whole works and dirks, so yeah.
So when you went, right, what's the submerged, like, I want to, like, put you in, into the moment. So did you, like, go someplace and where you were, like, you put your face in the cutout and it's like, you know, Darth Vader and Yoda, or like,
oh,
is there, did you go see,
yeah,
the new...
I can't remember, but yeah.
Okay.
After
he passed?
Yes.
Okay, then he was with you when you did this space thing.
Yeah.
And why did you ask for his socks?
I needed socks. Out of wool, scrap wool, and he used to call them mummy socks. And he used to say, I need another pair of mummy socks. Can you knit me another pair? And he'd come home from work, take off his shoes and socks and put his mummy socks on.
I don't even have to look at Jess because she's a Cancerian and she's a hot mess right now. He's good.
Thank you.
He's good. And did your ex-husband's new family tell you, like, they're adopting you as their mom?
His son did.
cool. Can I just, like, whisper something in her ear? Yes? Okay. Let's go right there.
Our brother passed away, and he died suddenly.
Don't say anything about him. But okay. Is your question about your brother?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Is his mom also passed?
Yep.
And she passed before him?
Yep.
Because I feel like she was there to greet him. Was there some type of, was he missing or somebody missing? Or was there, like, somebody in the family that was, like, out of the family for a while? Removed?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And where are the five kids in the family?
There's more than five.
Tell me.
Six.
So out of the psychic math now we know we do five minus one, right? Five are similar, one's different.
Okay.
So how can I have five being similar, one being different?
Not sure.
Is it that five are living and one's past? Or...
No, six are living.
There's six girls and.
So how many total?
Sorry, there's eight altogether in the siblings.
Nine.
Is that nine. Sorry. Yeah. Sorry.
Nine.
Thank you.
So there's
They're all sisters.
Six okay. girls and three boys have passed, males.
So I need to do in my way. It's got to be five and four, where five have something in common and four are different. So are five close in age, four further apart, or how many total passed?
Three.
No. I don't know how to split it, but I know it's got to be five and four. Mm. And I know that somebody passed from something impacted to their head or something that affects their head, correct?
One of the brothers, yeah.
Okay. Was that his fault? Like, could he take on the responsibility for what happened to him? Somebody's making me feel like they want to take on the responsibility for, like, how they got there. Like, what they did might have caused the circumstances that created how they got there. So, for example, if somebody was texting and driving or drinking and driving, that to me would be that. Whereas
it was football training.
Football training.
So then whatever it was that he was doing, something that he did created the circumstance that would have created that. You follow?
Mm.
And who's Anthony?
The brother first asking about, yeah.
That one that's passed?
Yep.
Okay. Is he Anthony Joe or Anthony J?
Mark Anthony.
So then I need to put a J connection to them as well. So on the same level, there's got to be a J. Meaning, like, out of the siblings, there's got to be a J connection. Who would that be?
There's Joe. Joe, brother-in-law.
Brother-in-law.
Okay. I don't... What was your question going to be about him?
I was just going to say he passed away suddenly, and when he died, we buried him. And then later on, because I was so upset of losing him, later on I remember him telling me that he wanted to be cremated. I was just... wondering if he's okay with being buried.
I'm going to tell you with confidence, after 32 years of doing this, nobody cares.
Yeah, I know. I know, but just that's what I thought of question.
And I say this, you know, when my uncle passed, I was only doing this work for 2 years. And in my wanting to console her, because they were, like, living at the cemetery, like, every day, I'm like, you don't have to go there. I go, he's not there. And she's like, really? That's where I put him. She's like, that's where I'm going to visit him. And I realized she needed to do that, right? So people do what they need to in order to grieve. Mm. And people have wishes, and sometimes those wishes cannot be met up with. Yeah. They don't hold a grudge seriously on the other side.
Yeah.
They understand why certain things can or can't be done, or why things happen in the way. And I think if we live our lives based upon sometimes what somebody on the other side would want, it would be wrong for us. People stay in relationships and dynamics that would be wrong for them because dad liked the guy, that type of thing. So if you remembered, like, oops, he wanted to be cremated and spread over the Blue Mountains, it's okay, if he's buried. It's not about where we park the car. It's about the driver and the connection that we have to that.
Mm-hmm.
Can I just say something?
Yeah.
Was somebody murdered? Like, murdered?
No.
There's a murder here.
Okay.
Murder?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm not comfortable with murders on camera. Was this unsolved?
No.
It was solved?
Mm-hmm.
I'm more comfortable then. I've had a couple of very uncomfortable moments where I revealed stuff where it was unsolved, mm-hmm. and then it kind of got out there, so I don't like that. I don't know who this is yet. I just know that they're taking on the fact that they were murdered, but they were murdered by somebody that I think they knew from what they're showing me. Like, this isn't like a random thing. It's like they're connected to the person. So I don't know if they were, like, shot by their husband, if they were, like, murdered by their boyfriend, but I'm feeling like this is a relationship that's connected. And they're letting me know that. Are there two people that were killed?
No.
I see two. This isn't like a murder-suicide, right?
No.
I see two people who passed tragically.
My second cousin...
Murdered?
Murdered, then he took his own life. Yeah.
And are you guys together?
We're friends, yes.
Okay, so your family's coming through together. Can I ask you what the relationship of the person for you that was murdered?
My flatmate.
What was the obsessive thing about your flatmate? Like, who, like the person that did this to them? Like, I feel like stalker, like obsessed.
I think so, but we didn't realize at the time.
So was it somebody that was like a friend or like a dating kind of connection?
No, we shared a house split in two,
right.
And they lived on the other side of the house.
Obsessed is the feeling.
Yes.
Would mistake any niceties as being overtures, right?
Yes.
Okay. And had you been away? You had been away when this happened?
Yes.
So you were away when you found out that this had taken place?
Yes.
Okay. And I don't know how long this has been, but I feel like I'm supposed to tell you that, like, not a day goes by where you don't reflect on the connection, the relationship, the conversations, and that even though you would have been connected for a short period of time, because I don't think you were, like, living together for a long period of time.
No, that's right.
Yeah. But the impact of the relationship stayed with you.
Yes.
And not because of the ending or the murder, but because of the dynamic.
Exactly.
And were you interviewed either for a newspaper or were you interviewed minus today, but were you on TV? Was there some type of camera in some way connected to you? Yes?
Yes.
Okay. Separate from this case? Like, were you on camera separate from that case?
Yes.
Okay. So, like, there's another reason why I would be putting you on camera?
Yes.
Okay. Just want to make sure that I'm interpreting what I'm seeing correctly.
No, that's okay.
Like, do you work in TV or do you do something that would put you on television?
No. I was just interviewed randomly the other week.
Gotcha. So this just happened?
Yes.
So it's a current event for you?
Yes.
So one of the things that I tell folks is that what they do is they bring up things that just happened, things that are current in your energy, to say, like, hey, I really am with you. Hey, I really do see what's going on. Are you not married?
No.
Can I go there?
If you like.
Okay. Did you also recently tell someone that you don't want to be in a quote-unquote, like, prison of a relationship?
Thank you, yes.
Okay. It's not that you're not open, you are open.
Yes.
You just don't want to be in the confines of what the definition is. You have your own kind of, you want to be free.
Yes.
Because somebody apparently was telling you that you're being too picky or difficult, correct?
Yes.
I don't know. I think I'd stick to what you're doing.
Thank you.
I think you're solid and you know who you are and what you want, and you don't feel like you're being defensive and putting things out there that will stop you from having a relationship.
Yeah.
I just think that you're just making choices of, like, I don't want to do second grade over again. Like, I've been in second grade. I don't want to do that.
Thank you.
So I don't know if you had been married and you had that experience,
yes.
But it's like, I've done that. Now I want to do me.
Yeah.
And I feel like you're doing you. And I'm getting a positive feeling about that.
Great.
So I guess don't settle.
Yeah.
Very cool. Thank you.
Thank you.